Oh, hello, Huckleberry. Hello yourself. What's that you got there? Dead cat. What's a dead cat good for? To cure warts with you, ninny. You, Huck, come here. Hello, Pap. You think you're a good deal of a big bug, don't you? Maybe I am, maybe I ain't. Now, don't give me none of your lip. You put on considerable many frills since I've been away. You're educated, too, they say. You can read and write. You think you're better than your father now, don't you? Because he can't. I'll take it out of you. Who told you you might meddle with such highfalutin foolishness, eh? Who told you? The widow. The widow. Who told the widow she could put in her shovel about a thing that ain't none of her business? Nobody ever told her. Well, I'll learn her how to meddle, and looky here, you drop that school, you hear? Your mother couldn't read, and she couldn't write neither before she died. None of the family couldn't before they died. I can't. Here you are swimming yourself up like this. I ain't the man to stand it, you hear? Now let me hear you read. George Washington was born on February 22nd, 1732, in Virginia. If his father had lived, he might have had the opportunity to complete his education in the... It's so. You can do it. I had my doubts, and they told me. Now look here. If I catch you around that school, I'll tan you good. First thing you know, you'll get religion, too. I never seen such a son. Well, there ain't no end to your heirs, and they say you're rich. Eh? How's that? Look here, don't give me no sass. I heard about you being rich. You and Tom saw you. I heard about it down the river, too. That's why I come. You get me that money. I ain't got no money. Oh, it's a lie. Judge Thatcher's got it. You call this a government? Here's the law. Stand ready to take a man's son away from him. A man's own son, which has had all the trouble and all the anxiety, all the expense of raising. Yes. And this is that man who's got that son raised at last and ready to go to work and begin to do something for him and give him a rest. The law up and goes for him. And they call that a government. Man can't get his rights in a government like this. Sometimes I find a notion just to leave this country for good and all. For 2 cents, I'd leave the blame country. Say, how much money you got in your pocket? I want it. I only got a dollar, and I want... You don't make no difference what you want it for. You just shell it out. Well, Pap took it, and he bit it to see it was good, and left to get some whiskey. Said he hadn't had a drink all day. After a few days of him laying around drunk with dream tremens and chasing me around with a knife, I got up and killed me a pig. And I smeared the blood around good to make everybody think I was murdered. And it took off to Jackson's Island with a runaway slave named Jim. We hole up on a raft. In that great getting up day morning, fare you well, fare you well. Here's a better day come, fare you well, fare you well. This is nice. I don't want to be nowhere else but here on this raft. It's a peaceful on a raft. Kings and dukes and emperors couldn't have any finer. How much do a king get? Well, they get $1,000 a month. They want it. Everything belongs to them. Ain't that gay? And what they got to do, Huck? They don't do nothing. They just sits around. Is that so? Of course, maybe when there's a war, but otherwise they just lazy around. They go hawking. They call each other your majesty and your grace and your lordship and such. And when things is dull, they fuss with the parliament and they whack their heads off. Of course, that French king, Louis XVI, got his head cut off and left a little boy called Dolphin, who would have been king. But they took and shut him up, and some say he died there. Poor little chap. Some says he came away and got to America. That's good, but he'd be pretty lonesome. There ain't no kings here in America, is there, Huck? No. Then he can't get no situation. What are you going to do? I don't know. Someone gets on the police, and someone learns people how to talk French. Why, Huck, don't the French people talk the same way we does? No, Jim, you wouldn't understand a word they said. Well, I'll be ding-busted. How'd that come? What so? I got some of their jabber out of a book. Suppose a man was to come up to you and say, Parlez-vous Francais, what would you think? Well, I wouldn't think nothing. I'd take and bust him over the head. I wouldn't allow no one to call me that. Oh, shucks, they ain't calling you then, Jim. So they're saying, you know how to talk French. Well, then why couldn't he say it? Well, he is a saying it. That's a Frenchman's way of saying it. Well, it's a blame ridiculous way, and I don't want to hear no more about it. Ain't no sense in it. Now, look here, Jim. Does a cat talk like we do? No, cat can't. Well, does a cow? No, cow don't another. Well, does a cat talk like a cow or a cow like a cat? No, they don't. Then it's natural and right for a cat and a cow to talk different from us? Most surely is. Well, then why ain't it natural and right for a Frenchman to talk different from us? Now, you answer me that. Is a cat a man? No. Well, then there ain't no sense in a cat talking like a man. Is a cow a man or is a cow a cat? No, she ain't. Well, then she ain't got no business to talk like either one or the other of them. Is a Frenchman a man? Yeah. Well, then, dad blame it, why don't he talk like a man?